how about a story of unstoppable force and an immovable object? Sounds badass?
Yeah.
Okay, but first tell me with a show of hands, who wants to listen to a happy story? And who wants to listen to a sad story? The reason I'm asking is, the story can be happy or sad, depending upon where I choose to stop. So this story takes place in the northern areas of Pakistan. And I don't think that many of us here know that Pakistan has got 40% of the tallest mountains in the world. So out of the top 20, we got 8 of them. It's summer of 2005, and I am on a 2-week camping trip deep into the mountains of Himalayas when I hear about this Slovenian alpinist, Tomaz Humar, being stuck on the rugged face of the mountain. Humar is regarded as one of the greatest high altitude climbers in the world. In the year 2000, he fell from the roof of his house, he broke his leg, shattered his ankle, 10 surgeries and doctors telling him that he'll not be able to walk again, could not keep him in the chair. He stood up and guess what? He decided to climb the killer mountain, Nanga Parbat. Nanga Parbat, with an altitude of 8,130 meters, is considered 9th highest mountain in the world. Nanga means naked and Parbat means mountain. So the name literally means naked mountain. And the mountain is named so because whenever the snow covers the face of the mountain, the frequent avalanches on its steep slopes wash the snow away. So the mountain is naked again. Nanga Parbat is not only really, really tall, it's also very, very big. If I want to cover all three faces, which are Raikot, Diamir, and Rupal face, it will take me approximately 3 weeks just to go around the mountain. So, the Rupal Valley is at 2900 meters, and the mountain top is more than 8100 meters. With an altitude of more than 5200 meters, Rupal face is considered to be the highest mountain face in the world. I've never seen anything bigger like this, and I'm incredibly close to the mountain. So if I want to look at the mountain top, I will literally have to go like this to look at the mountain top. And there are multiple routes on each of the face to climb the mountain. The three previously successfully attempted routes on the Rupal face are Messner's route, Polish-Mexican, and Seychelles route. But Humar decided to take a new route right through the middle of the Rupal face. A couple of days into the climb, he got stuck. He could not move forward or come back because of the bad weather and the constant avalanches around him. And he called for a rescue operation. Back at the base camp, my tent was only meters away from Humar's tent and the Pakistan military training camps. So I was able to follow the rescue operation up close. And it was not a simple task that you send any pilot with a helicopter and they will take him out. We needed high altitude helicopters and top of the class pilots to carry out the rescue operation. There were new pieces of information coming out every few hours, like the pilots are coming from France, the helicopters are coming from Switzerland. The junior level staff at the Pakistan military camp, they were not happy about that the foreign resources are being considered to carry out the operation. In their mind, they were taking it as a question mark on Pakistan military's ability to carry out the operation. One fine morning, I woke up to the sound of the helicopter. And because the rescue talks have been going on for a couple of days, I know what it is. So I got out of my tent and started looking for the helicopter in the open vast sky. I could not find anything at all, just the echoing sound of the helicopter. After what felt like a really long time, I was able to spot the helicopter. It was like a teeny tiny spot in that sky. As the helicopter drew closer to the mountain, it was at best 1/3 way up the Rupal face. The helicopter made several attempts through several angles, to get close to Humar, but they could not. I think the rescue operation went on for over an hour, but it was not successful. There was another attempt made later that day, but that was not successful again. Unfortunately, overnight, the weather turned bad. And it's Himalayan bad weather. So when it turns bad, it stays bad for days. And it's our last day at the camping site. So we packed our tents and started moving to our next destination. On my track back, I am overwhelmed with this thought that any small chances of survival this poor guy had are gone now. We were on road for a couple of days, and then we got to Hunza, which is my favorite town in northern Pakistan. The next morning, while we were having a lazy breakfast at the restaurant, the news broke on the national TV. Humar has been saved in a heroic rescue mission by two Pakistani pilots. The room got filled with celebrations. In 2009, Humar took another adventurous hike. The last line on his bio page reads, "He was waiting for an invitation, and she, the naked mountain, Nanga Parbat, has called him." Thanks a lot.